Sustainable fishing methods. How to catch fish and protect the ocean. The ocean, a vast and wondrous realm, is in peril. Irresponsible fishing practices have led to devastating consequences for marine life and ecosystems. In this video, we cover the most damaging fishing methods and their impact on marine ecosystems, and then look at how we can make fishing more sustainable and protect marine life. Let's dive in. The impact of fishing on the environment. Overfishing, unsustainable overfishing has pushed 90% of global fish populations to their limits or beyond. In the US alone, 25% of fish populations are overfished. Destructive fishing methods. Destructive methods like bottom trawling decimate seafloor ecosystems and sensitive habitats, taking decades to recover. Bycatch, the unintentional capture of non-target species, known as bycatch, results in the injury and death of thousands of turtles, sharks, dolphins, birds, and marine mammals. Illegal fishing. Between 11% and 33% of the annual global catch is illegal, which amounts to between 11 and 26 million tons. Illegal fishing often results in overfishing, excessive amounts of bycatch, and the fishing of threatened species. What are some of the most destructive fishing methods in use today? Blast fishing involves the use of dynamite or homemade bombs that are detonated in the water, indiscriminately killing all the fish and other marine life in the area. The dead fish are then collected from the surface or seafloor. This practice destroys everything in the blast zone, including the coral reefs and seabed habitats. Bottom trawling involves towing a huge trawling net across the seafloor, scooping up everything in its path. The practice is massively damaging to the seabed and corals. Huge amounts of bycatch die of exhaustion or injury in the net. Commercial trawl nets are huge, up to 300 feet wide, and can destroy acres of seabed in a single pass. Cyanide fishing involves spraying sodium cyanide into the habitat where the desired fish are found. The cyanide stuns the fish, making them easy to collect. This method is mainly used for collecting fish sold for aquariums. The method harms the fish themselves, the other organisms in the vicinity, and the coral and reefs. Up to 75% of fish caught this way die within 48 hours from the stress of being stunned and then handled, so each catch gathers more than needed to offset the mortalities. Muroami is a Southeast Asian practice that involves the use of an encircling net that is suspended above a coral reef. The reef is then pounded and often completely destroyed using rocks or heavy cement blocks suspended from cranes. Smashing the reef scares the fish and forces them out into the net. Ghost fishing. This usually happens when the fishers intentionally or unintentionally leave abandoned the fishing nets in the ocean, and many fish species and other marine life are entangled and suffocated in them. How can we protect marine life? Unsustainable fishing and marine habitat destruction are complex issues to resolve and overlap considerably with social, political, and economic issues, but it's not too late to save the ocean. Minimizing the impact of fishing on the environment involves using sustainable fishing methods, reducing bycatch, and protecting habitats from destruction. It also involves monitoring and controlling fishing to reduce illegal fishing and further prevent overfishing. Establish government regulations and international treaties. One of the best ways to reduce the adverse impact of destructive or exploitive fishing methods is to enforce government regulations and international treaties. These can include the strict prohibition of some environmentally unfriendly methods and proper regulation of some fishing practices. For example, the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea deals with aspects of overfishing. The treaty makes provision for specific zones for commercial fishing, periods for population recovery, and measures to prevent the exploitation of marine mammals. Remove fishing subsidies. Government subsidies paid to deep-sea fisheries make it financially viable for them to fish beyond naturally sustainable levels. Fishing in international waters outside of a country's exclusive economic zone is unregulated. Here, subsidized fisheries use trawling nets to drag the ocean and amass huge volumes of fish and other species with impunity. Encourage responsible aquaculture. Farming fish in captivity motivates fishers to manage their fish stocks effectively and maintain their numbers. It also reduces the strain on the ocean, as fewer fish need to be caught from it. However, there are drawbacks, and many carnivorous fish species, like salmon, need to be fed fishmeal, which often comes from ocean-caught fish. Thus, it is necessary to closely monitor and control aquaculture too. Consumer awareness and conscious consumption. Globally, consumers are becoming more aware of the impact of their buying and consumption habits. As awareness of the impacts of overfishing and destructive, unsustainable fishing practices grows, more and more consumers are choosing not to eat fish at all. Others are reducing their consumption or choosing fish that is certified as sustainable or farmed. Consumer awareness and conscious consumption. Globally, consumers are becoming more aware of the impact of their buying and consumption habits. As awareness of the impacts of overfishing and destructive, unsustainable fishing practices grows, more and more consumers are choosing not to eat fish at all. Others are reducing their consumption or choosing fish that is certified as sustainable or farmed. Certifications like the Blue MSC label for fish from fisheries that are certified by the Marine Stewardship Council are a convenient way for consumers to identify fish from sustainable sources. Sustainable fishing methods minimize harm to the environment, fish populations, and all marine life. These are some of the best fishing methods to use, and why. 6 Sustainable Fishing Methods. Hook and line fishing uses one short line and several hooks. The fisher monitors the line closely. If any non-target species are hooked, they can be quickly removed from the hook and released unharmed. Spear fishing or harpooning is usually used to catch larger fish species, like swordfish. The fish are speared with a barbed spear or harpoon, which is fired from a spear gun or thrown by hand. Each shot is aimed at an individual fish, so there is very little bycatch and fish have to be caught individually, which makes it difficult to overfly. Fishing traps or pods are stationary cages or nets that float in the water. Fish or shellfish are steered or lured into them, and once they are in, the design of the trap makes it difficult for the mature ones to escape, while smaller species and juveniles can swim out easily. Trolling involves the use of numerous fishing lines with baited hooks being dragged through the water by a moving vessel. This method targets only fish that are quick and will follow a fast-moving, baited hook, which reduces bycatch considerably. Purse seining involves dropping a net over a shoal of fish and drawing the edges together with a drawstring. When used for fish species that shoal alone and do not mix with other fish, there is little bycatch. Using nets that are sized correctly for the target species can further reduce any bycatch, as well as the risk of netting juveniles. Modified gear and thoughtful fishing practices can make all types of fishing less harmful. Using exclusionary devices, correctly sized nets, no-harm hooks, and fishing responsibly make a big difference to the impact of that fisher's activities. It's up to us to save the ocean by supporting sustainable fishing methods and making conscious choices. Together, we can protect marine life and preserve the wonders of the deep blue sea. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Share your thoughts in the comments below. We love hearing from our viewers and will respond to your questions.